Hallelujah. Welcome. We love you guys. Welcome to our little mini teaching we're doing tonight on the anointing. Now, this is part of my 20-something hour school of the anointing, but I'm going to target it tonight primarily at how a minister can seemingly live in sin, remain in sin, and the anointing, their gifting still operate. It's probably one of the most asked questions I get concerning the anointing. They say, well, what about such and such? What about such and such? And so I'm going to touch on that and be as concise as I can regarding certain things that have being exposed in the body at the moment. Now, the anointing, let's start on what is the anointing? The anointing is the Holy Spirit. That's it. That's the anointing. The New Testament, New Covenant anointing is the Holy Spirit. He is the one that gives the gift. He is the gift. So when you have the Holy Ghost, you can do all things by the Spirit of God. Now, we seem to have some ministers who have seemed to be having miracle meetings for the last 20 years, but being in absolutely horrendous sin, and the presence of God still turning up. So how is that possible? Well, let's put it this way. Those that have discernment discerned 20 years ago that there were problems. But as usual, let's just sweep it under the charismatic carpet and deal with it later. Then 20 years later, there's more and more people that have been hurt and damaged by what should have been dealt with then. Now, the anointing is the impartation of God's ability on somebody's life to do something. And the gifts and the callings of God are without repentance. If you're called to be an evangelist, a teacher, a pastor, teacher, prophet, elder, deacon, administration, helps, all that sort of thing, you will be anointed and equipped to do that job. Now, when you become proficient at it, in other words, you've been doing it for a while, you can actually seem to bypass the need to call on the Holy Ghost for help. It just becomes a thing that you do. It becomes a work. And a lot of ministers, sadly, have a very professional working relationship with Holy Spirit, but on a personal level, there's nothing. It just doesn't happen. They don't just get into His glory presence and just worship His presence, worship You, Jesus. It's just all about, give me words, Lord, give me words, give me license plates. Yes, I see that Facebook profile. Yes, I can memorize. Yes, they need a new washer. Yes, George needs a new car. And all that sort of stuff. Now, with the anointing, there's three different types of all levels. You know, I don't like to use the words like that because it kind of categorizes things, but to break it down, we have what is referred to by many as the believer's anointing. Every believer has the anointing. That anointing helps us believe. Believe it or not, that's the believer's anointing. Then there is the ministerial anointing, which is an anointing that can come upon a minister for a certain task to minister, like in Luke chapter 4, verse 18, where Jesus says, you know, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He's anointed me to heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons, and all that type of stuff. Very specific, very different from the believer's anointing. Then there's a third type, the corporate anointing, where two or three gather in my name, there I will be in the midst of them. So whenever we get together, whenever there's a group of people, you can have the biggest flesh bucket from Canada up on stage doing his show, and there will still be a strong anointing moving among the people. Why? Because God loves His kids. Rain it back in, Matthew. Rain it back in. Spirit of a prophet is subject to a prophet. That's better. Now, there can still be miracles, signs, wonders, dead raisings, healings, you name it. And that minister has very little or nothing to do with it. A lot of it is the believer's anointing on the believers in the meeting and the corporate anointing working together. Now, you can train yourself in the anointing to be able to discern what someone's operating in. Some people just seem to, when they come into church, all of a sudden just be able to prophesy because they're tapping into what's in the atmosphere. You take them outside of that environment, they couldn't tell you anything. Bring them in, kaboomba. They've had that, they've tapped in. They've learned how to tap in and flow. And sadly, a lot of ministers these days, that's what they know how to do. They're that busy in their itinerary that there's no personal time for them and the Holy Ghost just to spend a month or two or three or six or 12 just enjoying Him. They're out, got to give words of this and words of that and words of this and words of that. Today's prophets, all you got to do is just release the presence of Jesus. And He and His Word, He is the living Word, the living stone. He is our bread, He is our drink, He is our wine, He is our everything. He gets released and the people get fed. And the prophet doesn't actually have to say or do anything. That's when you know they're carrying some serious whack. Six manifestations of the anointing. You got to preach the gospel. Heal the brokenhearted, bring deliverance to the captives, recover your sight to the blind, set at liberty those that are oppressed, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Jubilee, restore what was lost after 50 years. Now, text from council. The government likes sending. It's not a storm, it's a fire warning. Of course it is, it's Australia. We've just had the end of winter. So, the anointing. People can operate powerfully, seem powerfully under the anointing. But you'll be able to tell by the fruit on their life. You'll be able to tell by the company they keep. When you go into their house, you'll feel the presence of Almighty God. When you get around them, you'll feel the tangible drawing. That love cloud will just bring you in. Now, it's as if the spotlights are being turned on and, there's going to be a lot of rats, a lot of charismatic rats running for cover because the lights have been shone on and they're not getting turned off anytime soon. And there's going to be more that are caught up in these dirty little scandals and little horrid things that have been going on. But rest assured, the Holy Spirit had nothing to do with it. He was not enabling anything. He was not covering anything up. It's just that His gifts are without repentance. So they can preach, they can teach, they can heal the sick and cast out demons and still be molesting kids and other people at the same time. That sounds crazy. It sounds utterly redonkulous. So the one thing that you can test it by is the presence of God. By knowing, hang on a minute, this person's not operating in their anointing. They're operating in that person's faith or the corporate anointing. And that's how a lot of people, sadly too many ministers, get around being caught. Because people think, well, the anointing's there. How can they be in sin? God's grace is not enabling them to be in sin. It's just He's given the gift. He's not going to take it back. But He will lift His presence off. And it may not happen instantly, but it will happen. It is the goodness of God that leads us to repentance. Some are just that narcissistic and up themselves that They don't get it. It doesn't matter what happens. It's not until they're locked behind bars getting probed by Jesus from Mexico that they're going to really think, oh, geez, maybe I should have changed my ways years ago. So I hope that adds a little bit of clarity to why someone can be supposedly so anointed and yet be doing such horrendous, horrible things. So I'm going to be continuing this teaching. This is from my manual. It's about 20 hours, so I'm going to redo this over the next 2 weeks. And we'll get it out there in like half hour lot, so it's not too much to watch at once, and make it available for free download. But for those of you that are hurting, we love you. We just wish that we could give you all a great big holy hug. So know that no matter where you are on this round ball, there are people that love you and care for you deeply. And I know that the Radosties and others have set up support networks for people that need help. And it's just sickening that Bill Johnson and Rick Joyner and others have known for many years that this has been going on. I won't say what I was going to say, but we love you. Stay safe. And let's learn together in the Holy Ghost. All right? We got your back. We love you. See ya.